See if I can hit him in the head. Jeez, this. Quick on the draw there, my god. Oh yeah, rusty musket, broken. So it's a long range gun, obviously. Compared to my short range little pistol thing. Two of them. Actually, I think there might be three of them. Oh shit. Lots of arrows. Lots of arrows. He went right between his legs. Oh god, there's another one. Okay, I got this. Oh, can't carry? Yeah, I can't carry. Ooh, I'm up to 16 arrows. Oh right, they're shooting arrows at me. I guess I had them in their inventories. Nice. April 21st. Drifted 8 hours owing to fierce wind and heavy squalls. April 22nd. The storm worsened and we drifted most of the day. High seas and constant lashing rain drowned nearly 2 dozen poultry in the hold and damaged sundry other supplies. April 23rd. Sighted the Rebecca before noon. She was badly damaged by the storm and will have to turn back for Plymouth. We will sail on alone. Didn't even see you. Dug up a Spanish sea chart showing a large section of unfamiliar coastline. World map. Oh my! This game is quite large, isn't it? Damn. I was only looking at my own location. Wow, that is impressive. Okay, what have I found? A bunch of things. Drifted 8 hours. Foul sorcery. This way? Heard a noise. Yes, chest. Charm of Ferocity. Inflict 150% melee damage and attack 5% faster. Are there something here? Oh. The remains of a soldier are partly buried in the loose soil. The cause of death is not obvious. Dug up a finely made reed flute. You hear nothing else in the light. I guess that means I need to switch it over. Okay, there's a fast travel system. So I suppose I could use that, huh? Oh, wow. That's interesting. I wonder if it almost makes it too easy. It's damn convenient, though, that's for sure. Do you recognize this reed flute? I remember thinking how sad it would be here without Edmund's music. An Indian gave him that flute after hearing him play. I found it near the remains of a man who had been killed near the encampment. Then that's why he never came back. The skull is stuck to the ground. Perhaps you can dislodge it if you pull harder. Okay, it's very faint. I think it's this direction. Is it just back? Back to the fort? No, I'm not going back to the fort. I believe I have found your skull. What was lost has been found. I shall give you something in return. You are most generous. Crude charm of swiftness. Return to its rightful place. Move 4% faster. Am I hearing anything? Yes. This way. It can be extremely faint sometimes. Mary Barnes and her son Edward are the latest to show signs of sickness. If Eustace Cage cannot find some remedy, the strange contagion may soon claim its 10th and 11th victims. God, they had a lot of problems here, didn't they? Besieged? Suicides? Accidental deaths? Plague? Hello there, spirit. I must report to the captain. Is this your flute? It is. Then you must be Edmund Gotham. Yes, you have given me back my name. Gregory Ward said you showed him a Spanish encampment. I remember pointing through the brush, to where the Spaniards were gathered around their fire. We counted 2 dozen men at least. I showed him the map I found lying in the grass. The wind must have carried it away from the camp. He looked very grave when he saw it. I suddenly thought to ask him what he was doing so far from the fort. What did he say? That he always loved hearing me play the flute. Found a crude map of the area around Fort Henry with place names in English and notations in Spanish, suggesting it was drawn by an Englishman and modified by a Spaniard. I don't hear anything. Keep thinking every little sound is it. Wait, I think there's something from here. Yes. Oh, this is back to the fort, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Edmund Gotham found this map near the Spanish encampment. I remember now. We met by chance near Dodd's Hill. It was nearly dark. He said he'd found a Spanish encampment and showed me where it was. And then he showed me this map. He said we must report to Captain Eastgrove. You were concerned about the map? Because I drew it. Why? I'm a Catholic, though I had to swear I wasn't to come here. My duty is to the Pope in Rome, not to a heretic king. And to my mom at home, who can live easier with those Spanish coins I gave her. Edmund Gotham didn't return from patrol because of that map. I knew I couldn't let him come back to Fort Henry, or I'd be hung for sure. But it made me sad to think I'd never hear him playing that flute again. This is a very sad place. Just horrible things have just been happening constantly. I have a gift for you again. Spanish sea chart. Why are you giving it to me? It'll come in handy if we manage to find a ship. That is a shrewd notion. I shall hold on to it. Also, I have this reed flute that belonged to Edmund Gotham. It's strange that she asks me why I'm giving it to her every time. I wonder if my answers matter. So that you can entertain me. Entertain me! I am bored. I thought you might enjoy learning to play it. I shall practice dutifully, but only when you're out of earshot. Fair enough. How much money do I have? Also, can I sell anything? Crack longbow? Yeah, that's worse. Rusty musket. Oh, okay, so I could have sold this. Oh, wait, no, this isn't the broken one, is it? This is just rusty. Yeah, there's a difference. Very slow, but the range is fair. Okay. Okay. Reasonably fast. Yeah, I love the slow reload on these weapons and the animations. Very cool. What do I want to buy? Well, I think my bow is my most important weapon, so... Yeah, let's wait until I can get the common longbow. So I'm going to save up to 400. You know, I'm thinking, what if I turned off... I can turn off the crosshair, right? Yeah. Yeah, that's weird. You can turn off the crosshair, but the problem is the iron sights aren't really sights at all. The actual center of the screen is like... Okay, let's see how good I am at aiming. Confuse myself by moving my view around, and then let's see if I can hit the left corner of that rock. Eh, not bad. I'm gonna turn it back on, though. Nothing else in the light. Wait, didn't I hear nothing in the dark? What do I do then? I still can't dig these things up, right? No. Still don't have a spade. Nobody knows what happened to the spade. Yep, nothing else in the light. Okay, I guess I just need to continue on. Find my own way. Forgot to heal, but it's okay. I'm only down a little bit. Do remember seeing an encampment here. Where am I going? I'm going south, pretty much. Yeah, going straight down here. Cool. I do believe you saw me. Out of my way, bushes. I'm guessing you heard that? Other enemy? Yes, you did. Okay, so they did hear me running. Or maybe they didn't? Maybe they did, but then they lost me? Oh no. Bombs? You massive asshole. Whoa. That is a giant. It sounds like a bear, literally. God, unlock Southgate destination. That's a lot of arrows. Yeah, it might be better to shoot it in the foot. Because everywhere else is just armor. Come here. Oh, I can't take you. I'm already full. The gate is kept closed by night. Yeah, my god, this game is really large. I really didn't expect it to be so large. I hear treasure. Or maybe a note. The Warrens grew frantic when he realized where Captain Harper proposed to lead his expedition, saying we must never venture into that forest, lest we disturb the evil that slumbers there. The captain tried to offer reassurances that we would tread lightly, but the Warrens rose up in wrath and swore to leave none of us alive should we defy him in this matter. Wait, here's something else. Mary Shortridge, age 28, succumbed to sickness. The age of 28. Yeah, life expectancy back then was not great. I think it saw me. I'm hearing a lot of plinks, which means a lot of deflected shots. Okay, there's still, I think, another one. Yeah, there's definitely at least one more. Critical hit in the knee. Dearest sir or madam, I have acquired several new items that may be of modest interest. I humbly submit them for your consideration. As you know, I happily accept barter as well as coin. Yes, another quiver would be nice, but... oh, I can finally afford the common longbow. Okay, so let's see. Range is short, obviously it's a short bow. However, it's very fast at firing, so that's good for close-range enemies. Gotcha. Well... let's go ahead and buy it, huh? It does what, 5 more damage than the current one I have, I think? Yeah, let's go for it. Yeah, 35 to 40. Mm-hmm. Deflect chance, 15%. Oh, it's got less of a deflect chance. Nice. Alright, let's sell this crap. Don't need anything else. With Benedict Harper's expedition party now long overdue, and presumed killed by savage treachery, the Council has chosen to make James Markley's conditional governorship permanent. The Council asks that you show him all respect and courtesy due to the Lord Governor of his colony. Due the Lord Governor of his colony. Okay, now I'm hearing noises. Well, I'm actually getting a major performance hit here. For the first time, I'm not getting 60 FPS. Huh. I love that wind. Yeah, something's seriously performance-heavy in this direction. Something heard me. I wonder if I can how easy it is to rehide. Weather shortbow boken. Boken. Broken. It's a boken shortbow. Boken. Words exist. Use them. Oh, crap. You're actually running. Oh, okay. So they run away from you. Okay, those are actually really dangerous enemies, and I'm almost dead. I need to go back and heal. I wish there was a little bit more indication that you're really low on health. You know, some sort of like a full screen, sort of everything goes red or black or something sort of effect. I like that. Because the UI is very small, which is fine. But, yeah, it's hard to tell that I'm almost dead. I've peered down there and saw my health at like 17 before, and it didn't feel like I'd really taken much damage. I don't want to drop my common longbow. I paid a lot of monies for this. Okay, this way. Oh, looks like I'm going towards the fort. Yeah, what's around here, though? Hold on. Let's go north. A little bit north, northwest. There's something up here. Oh yes, I hear something. It's one of those bear things. And shoot her right in the ass. Maybe I should shoot in the head. I don't know, it just seems like just piercing the armor. Just not great. I wasn't reloaded. Yeah, I don't know whether to shoot them in the head or not, honestly. I mean, obviously their feet are more exposed. Doesn't even make a clink noise anymore. Am I just hearing? Oh, this is what I'm hearing. The bows the Indians use are smaller than ours and less powerful. Yet even mere youths can kill a bird in flight without wasting an arrow, for they learn to shoot at an early age and practice nearly every day. The best of their archers can loose 10 arrows before the first hits the ground. Those would be short bows. I want one. I want to machine gun them. Machine gun arrows, yes. Moving towards the fort, aren't I? Yes. It just sounds like it's coming from everywhere. I'm just gonna move towards the fort. Which means south, a little bit east. This way, right? Yeah. Oh yeah, I see it. I wonder if you shoot them when the wind is blowing, if that, like, masks the sound of them dying. Okay, this is actually very, very bad. I have no more healing. And I just took more damage. Shit. I kind of want to go all the way back for water, because if I don't, there's a pretty good chance I'm dead. Shit. Cannot fast travel when enemies are near. Alright, I gotta get away from here. I need water. Alright, I can just fast travel there, save me the 20 seconds, I guess? I don't know. I'm not sure how I feel about the fast travel system. I mean, it's obviously convenient, there's no doubting that, but at the same time, it seems cheap. Let's see if I can take down the highlights a bit. A little bit less extreme. Atop this makeshift table, you find a single black pearl of modest size and quality. Dug up a grimy playing card, it is a king of diamonds. Dug up a plain leather coin pouch, it contains several coins. My dreams are often troubled of late by the panic of drowning. Not in water, but in loamy soil. It fills my mouth so that I cannot scream. Jesus, that sounds terrifying. Thank you, makeshift bridge. Okay, they'll hear me inside if I run, so let's not run. I'm just exploiting their pathfinding by being up on a rock. Shit, I think I'm stuck. Oh no, I'm stuck. Fuck! I can't. Oh! Yes! Keep going! Come on. There we go! Come on. I hear more. But if there's more, why aren't they coming out? Lawrence Spendlove, beloved chaplain. Yeah, there's more in there, but it's not coming out. And where's my damn spade? I'm finding so many things I could dig up if I had a spade. Dug up a crude, stunted wooden carving whittled in what is probably supposed to be the shape of a nude woman. It doesn't particularly resemble one. Wood shavings are scattered on the ground here. Like this. This is, needs a spade, right? Yeah. There you are. Hiding in the corner. Oh, another bell. Figure out the tale of what happened here. $240 coins. Can almost get a quiver. Yeah, so you can upgrade your capacity on every kind of weapon, it looks like. Increase of stealth. Whether by foul treachery or cruel fate, the Constance is but splinters in the deep. Now I fear we shall never sail away from here again. Trapped, besieged, be plagued. The sentry claims he saw a dark shape moving amongst the graves. But we found no prints in the soil. The next morning, we discovered George Causey's grave dug up and his skull missing. I'm hearing noise from a bunch of different places, but I think I heard it from this direction. It's hard to tell. I do hear something out here. Yes, I see them. Oh, I wanted to one-shot him. No such luck. What are you doing? Wait, I don't have my tomahawk? I don't have my tomahawk. What the hell happened to it? Did I throw it and never get it back? Whoops. How much does one cost? It's not too bad. I'd rather save my money, though. I really don't need it. Next thing I want to buy is a short bow, I think. I want to be able to shoot a lot of arrows very quickly up close. Because right now I have nothing that can deal with anything up close quickly. The quickest thing is just my longbow, but obviously that's not exactly ideal. Something in that general direction. Let's switch it over to nighttime, though. Or the dark time, whatever this time is. Anyone to speak to? No? Something in that direction. Oh, maybe back down to that camp where I got the stuff from. Coming from everywhere. I know there's one more. I have lost my way. The sound of the bell will guide you. Return. Oh my god, it's dark. There's at least two of the sounds I'm hearing, one from inside of here and one from outside. Captain Wilkinson hasn't returned. Where did you last see him? He went to gather firewood. Who are you? Samuel Millard. Do you recognize this wood carving? I was whittling it to pass the time. I was anxious, wondering whether the captain would return. He was late coming back. George Causey lies here. Was your head taken from you? Stolen it was. I shall seek to return it to you. Corruption, I see. All right. The sound I hear is really distant in that direction. Did I not get anything for you? No? Oh no, shouldn't have gone on the rocks again. It's Arma all over again. Never go on the rocks. Here it is. What the hell is that thing? I think I killed it. I hope I killed it. What the... Oh, you were invisible for a second. How rude. Okay, I think I got that thing by shooting it in the head. The rest of its body seemed to be made of shadow. Silver skull. What's going on here? A musket ramrod is embedded in the tree. Someone must have failed to remove it from the barrel before firing. Huh, I guess if you did leave that in the barrel and shot it, it would shoot it out, wouldn't it? I don't think it's very aerodynamic, though. Dug up a splintered arrow with fletching in the Indian style. The soil in this area is heavily trampled. It seems a battle was fought here. Corruption. Alright, bring it on. I don't like that noise. I think I just need to go back to the sentry post now. I found a battleground near here. It was like fighting ghosts. The savages would rise up out of the grass, fire their arrows, and then disappear before he could even aim. This ramrod was stuck in a tree. I was reloading when one of them popped up right in front of me. I didn't think, I just fired. Then, I was sitting on the ground, my shoulder throbbing and my mouth tasting like blood. Captain Wilkins had told me to get up and fight. He said it like I was a coward. I believe I have found your skull. Though it is coated in silver and carved with strange markings, I am restored to myself because of you. Please accept a gift for your troubles. You are very generous. Nothing else in the darkness. It seems I need to reload my common pistol. Nothing more to say, right? No. Back to the daytime. Oh, hello. I remember we stayed at this fort for a couple of days. The men stationed here were grim and sullen. My mother told my sister and I not to go out alone. I was glad to leave. I have a gift for you. A black pearl! I'm wondering what would happen if you just kept saying you're beautiful. That's very strange. A very strange thing to say at a time like this. Why am I giving it to you? Because it might be cursed and I don't want it in my hands. Most generous of you, but you keep it. I insist. Okay. The crude figure that Samuel Wright carved. It is grotesque. Why are you giving it to me? I thought you might like a doll to play with. Oh my god. In case you wanted to make something with it, then I shall keep it. Is that a coin pouch? Flipping the coins in the air and guessing how the land might entertain you. In case you get back to England and want to spend the money on something for yourself. It might be useful for storing small items. I suppose. It might have some utility. It would be wasteful to discard it. I'm still not sure if I should be, like, keeping that stuff. So wait a minute, I'm keeping the Black Pearl, right? Where is it? Oh, does it not even show up in my inventory? I don't think it does. Huh. Oh, I've got a lot of money, too. Let's mark all that as red. Alright, let's switch the color and contrast. Makes a big difference, huh? Oh my god, if anything, that's way too colorful, actually. What's a realistically green? Right there? Yeah, that's a little bit too green. I'm trying to get it to look as realistic as possible. 6? Yeah, that's more reasonable. Still doesn't quite look like daylight. I need to tweak some more settings to get it right, but yeah, this is a pretty damn good looking game. So I'm about to end the episode in case you didn't notice. Just wanted to take a look at how everything looked in a different light. God, I love the way everything blows in the wind. It's a pretty damn good looking game. It's really beautiful, especially the vegetation. Some really nice vegetation. And the way it interacts with the wind. Yeah, I mean, it's a lot more pleasant to look at the game like this, there's no doubt about that. But at the same time, this way, the other way, is a lot more atmospheric. Okay, that's... Yeah, I do think the default is way too contrasty. What did I have it down to? It's like... That? Yeah, that's more reasonable. It's still a little bit too dark. There. Something like that. I think that's close to where I had it before. This is definitely more atmospheric, and it seems like it's part of the story that the color has been drained out of the world. I saw that on the Steam page. Like, in the description for the game is saying, like, why has the color been drained from the world? Why is this place cursed? So, I know it's supposed to look like this. Which is why I want to keep playing it like this, but at the same time, it is a lot less pleasant to look at. But it's not supposed to be pleasant to look at. Or is it? I don't really know. It's very strange. I think there's pluses and minuses to either art style. So, I don't know. I think I'm just gonna lean towards keeping it more like this. Again, I do think the original settings for the light and dark is just way too harsh, but if you turn it down to just more of a slightly harsh black and white, it's more reasonable. And I think I'm inclined to leave it more this way just because it's what the developers intended. Yeah. Anyway, I'm really enjoying this game. It's quite good. It's got a, you know, it's... Well, I guess just like I said, sort of an action-adventure FPS. It's basically what it is. It's got elements of a first-person shooter, it's got elements of an adventure game. You know, you pick up notes and you talk to people, learn about what's happened, shoot things. It's pretty damn creepy. It's quite good. Yeah. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I will be back soon.